geriatric assessment is very relevant for nurses because most of these assessments in practical settings are actually done by nurses, because as nurses it's really the comprehensive health assessment, how they're doing at home, how they're functioning, what support, how they're getting their groceries, are they able to take their medication, that's all within the nursing domain. So the consensus guideline really talks about what do we have about evidence, what we know if we do these comprehensive geriatric assessments in oncology settings. We get a lot of extra information that oncology teams, if they just do their standard of care, wouldn't get, because they don't have the time and a systematic way of inquiring about all these functional issues in these older patients. So as a nurse, we could take a lead in doing these assessments, and of course the geriatrician or another physician is involved in it for the medical exam and for discussing the optimization of medication. But for the most part in practice, nurses typically do the first bulk of the assessment, then the doctor does some of the more medical aspects of the assessment, and then together with the patient you discuss the findings. And in this older adult population, it's very important to also involve the older adults, because as a team you might identify issues, and particularly comprehensive geriatric assessments, several studies have shown, particularly the large Belgian studies by Cindy, have shown that you have about 70% of new issues that were not known before. But if you're 80 and you've had a certain lifestyle, like you're not willing to change everything. So it's really a prioritization with the patient, like would they like to work on the fall issue, because you can identify that the medication is not optimal, that they have fall risk, that they have a poor nutritional status. But you have to work together with the patients to talk about, this is what we found, this is what we think we can do better, and work on the patients with what they are willing to address or able to address, or what they would like to tackle first, because a lot of these older adults, because they have multiple diseases and multiple treatments, you can't expect to change their whole lifestyle and healthcare regimen overnight. You need to build trust, and I think that's also where the nurses come in, because this assessment takes time. You have an opportunity to talk about issues that are concerning as a patient and as a nurse, and seeing them on regular intervals, you really have the opportunity to build trust and come back on these issues. And over time, maybe you cannot tackle everything on your first appointment, but over time, after you work at one of the issues identified, after that they obviously trust you if you were able to successfully help them with their health or care issue, and then tackle the next issue and continue onwards. I guess taking into account that this is an older adult population, so new issues will come up during the treatment. They could have a new fall, they could have their spouse suddenly falling in, needing care, so they need extra care at home and things like that. So I think the nursing role in geriatric assessment and management is really crucial, because you have the ability to do most of the assessments. It is within our domain, and then we can get referrals in agreement with medical team, whether occupational therapy or social work or all the other allied health team members that are important in this patient population. But obviously the nurses are more in a position to take the case management or the care coordination role for a lot of these older adults. Well, I think the SIO guidelines that were developed are still very valid. There's just more and more new studies to support what we've been doing, and we can probably, in the guidelines were less certainty about certain impacts, and now there's more studies to say, well, yes, we can be more firm in these recommendations perhaps. But I think the barriers of implementing these interventions are really at an healthcare organizational level too, because for geriatric assessment and management, obviously as an institution there needs to be support, whether it's the geriatric team being brought into the oncology team, or have a more formalized referral pathway, or having access to an inpatient geriatric team. Like, to be able to implement this in clinical practice, there need to be some established collaboration between geriatrics and oncology to make this happen, or if the oncology team takes it on themselves, there needs to be training in, like, oncology nurses need to be trained in geriatric assessment and management, and having their backup geriatric expertise when they need it and things like that. So I think that's quite a challenge around the world, because there's shortage of geriatric experts around the world. It's not the most favorable specialty in nursing school. It's definitely not the most favorable, considered favorable specialty with medical students. So both nurses and geriatricians and things like that, there's only so many numbers. So I think that's the biggest barriers, to have some kind of formalized structure, whichever is best for your country and your healthcare setting, but you need to have a formalized collaboration or some way of collaborating to do these assessments and management, because the assessment takes time. It takes 1 to 2 hours. If you do full comprehensive assessment, then you have to discuss as a team what you think are the issues and what are potential solutions, because the older population is so heterogeneous. Like, you can be at fall risk or you can have 2 falls, but is it because you were hypotensive? Were you dizzy getting up in the morning? Or were you falling because you had a foot problem and you have no balance? So there's all these underlying issues that as a team you need to figure out why they're falling and when it's happening, so that you know the best intervention. So it's very much more personalized, tailored to the patient. And so that takes time to do that. And in oncology settings, if you have your oncology practice, and around the world, they're so busy, and I don't know what the standard is in most countries, but somewhere between 15 minutes and 30 minutes for the average consultation, I'm guessing. But if the assessment takes 2 hours, and then the management plan, and then making sure that you have all the referrals. So if you want OT involved, then obviously somebody needs to be in charge of arranging the referral, but also checking up with the older adults, like, did they actually get a call from occupational therapy? Because a lot of older adults, because they have multiple diseases and multiple issues, they have so many different appointments and so many things are happening at the moment. They're diagnosed with cancer and so many medications are changed and things like that. So nurses can really take a lead in coordinating that and getting in contact with OT, PT, or whatever is involved, but also checking back on, did they actually show up? Did you see the dietitian, or why didn't the dietitian come? Or what did the dietitian receive recommendations? Then I would like to know what she discussed and things like that. And because all these different perspectives can have their input, but somebody needs to bring it together for the patient, to discuss it as a comprehensive approach, and that they don't see 20 individual patients. I think the strength is in the comprehensive geriatric assessment model, that it's a team-based approach and not 20 different individual, because health and all the adults is so intercorrelated, because falls you can address with medication changes, you can address with exercise, but it could also be totally due to weakness because they're not eating. So then obviously you can get exercise, but you also need to get the dietitian involved for those kind of optimization. It's never a problem in isolation. It's always something multifactorial that requires a multifactorial approach, and nurses can really play a lead in the assessment and overviewing the care that's been, that it's provided in the best way for the patient.